and welcome to St Mark's Armagh. You're really welcome to be part of this service today. I'm the curate and my name is Jeff Hamilton. A sentence of scripture, Psalm 27 verse 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? And an opening prayer. Almighty God, you have made us for yourself. Therefore, our hearts are restless till they find rest in you. Teach us to offer ourselves to you this day, that we may know your peace, and in the world to come may see you face to face. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our first hymn today is, O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder.
Thank you.
and the collect for purity. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly lovely and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And our reading from Mark chapter 12, beginning at verse 41. Jesus sat down opposite the place where the offerings were put and watched the crowd putting their money into the temple treasury. Many rich people threw in large amounts, but a poor widow came and put in two very small copper coins, worth only a few pence. Calling his disciples to him, Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, this poor widow has put into the treasury more than all the others. They all gave out of their wealth, but she, out of her poverty, put in everything, all she had to live on." This is the word of the Lord. This is one of my favourite stories. It's such a powerful story. And just before we go to the story, I want to drop back a few verses, because there's an encounter between Jesus and a religious expert in verse 38. Jesus has a public discussion with this man about the religious law. This unnamed man asked Jesus to identify the greatest commandment. And here's what Jesus said. Jesus replies by stating, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these." Love is a small word, but it has big consequences. I don't know if you've maybe at one time been at a lake or been at the seaside, and you've lifted a stone and you've thrown it into that lake and you've seen the ripple effects. Love makes a big splash. In our reading today, Jesus is sitting watching people giving money into like their collection, their church collection, and many rich people give large amounts. Then a poor widow comes and drops in very little. But the lady, the person who gave the least, is actually the person who gave the most. And I love that, because really, maybe too easily we judge people on our first impressions, and that's not how Jesus engaged with people. Jesus called his disciples to him and said, "I tell you the truth, this poor widow has given more than all the others who are making contributions, for they give a tiny part of their surplus, but she, poor as she is, has given everything she had to live on." Jesus wasn't concerned about the amount of the gift, but rather the state of the heart of those who were giving. Jesus wasn't swayed by outward expressions. The contrast in this passage is stunning between the arrogance of the rich and the wholehearted devotion of this poor widow. We shouldn't be defined by striving, achieving, or conquering. Our lives are not possessions to be defended, but gifts to be shared. Generosity has many levels. God calls us to think generously, to speak generously, and to act generously. That's a challenge for you. That's a challenge for me. But may it be a reality in our lives. Just to conclude, the Christian life is not devoid of problems or difficult times. God doesn't give us divine immunity from challenges, but God is with us in the midst of our challenges. Today, may we be aware of God's loving arms wrapped around us, and may we know in our hearts that God will never forsake us and never leave us. Amen. And our second hymn today, and our final hymn, and it's one that we all love, "Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. Let us just take a moment and let us pray. O God, who art the author of peace and lover of concord, in knowledge of whom standeth our eternal life, whose service is perfect freedom, defend us, thy humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in thy defence, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And together we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And the blessing. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.